Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Eternal Quest Week in Conversations and in association with the Ahmedabad Book Club. And let me tell you one thing, today's episode is really special to my heart because I'm going to take this opportunity and I'm going to take this chance to give a tribute to my alma mater and my school, SN Kansagra, and a very favorite teacher of mine, Ms. Biju Damani. We welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me. Thank you, the Eternal Quest and the Ahmedabad Book Club. And thank you, Dwiti.
Thank you, ma'am. So, you know, basically, it's like for a student, it's always like an honor to, you know, interview a teacher when I've been seeing you like while I was growing up. So I am really happy over here to be with you sharing the screen. So talking about Ms. Biju Damani, she's an educator working in SN Kansagra School, Rajkot, Gujarat. And she's the mastermind of social entrepreneurship project Galaxy Bazaar, which was started in 2005. And the project has raised more than 1 crore 50 lakhs in the last year to provide equal educational opportunities to girls from underprivileged section of the community. And inculcated values of ethical entrepreneurship in Ms. Biju's business students. She has also started innovative product and marketing competition for students where they look around their own community, spot a problem, and come up with an innovative product to solve that problem. Students consider solving problems, and she has won 21 national and international awards from UNESCO SDG Teacher Ambassador 2017 to Forbes Good Smartin Award 2014. She's been a TEDx speaker twice, and Ms. Biju Damani wants to make a change in the life of the students and those around her. Welcome again, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I'm so proud introducing you today.
it's a different experience even for me to kind of being interviewed by my students.
Exactly, yes.
Really, it's a pleasure.
So at the very beginning of your career, if I'm not wrong, you were a market manager, but since last 20 years, you've been an educator. So what was that inspiration behind the change, and how did the journey begin?
Dwiti, just like every other college going student, after finishing my MBA, you know, my master's in business administration with marketing management, I joined a dot-com company as a marketing manager. And, while working for that particular company as a marketing manager, I just realized that there is a vast gap between what we learn in the curriculum, in the degree, in the classrooms, and what the industry actually requires. There is a vast gap between the two. So keeping that in mind, I took this radical decision, you know, you can call it an insane decision of leaving my corporate career and deciding to join as a teacher. I started my career as a computer teacher with SN Kansagra School, like the Galaxy Education System. And amazingly enough, you know, I was given the job of teaching right from grade 1 to grade 12. I was used to teach computers to grade 1 to grade 12. And believe me, it really helped me such a lot in, you know, becoming the teacher that I am today.
Okay, wonderful, ma'am. So since 2005, Galaxy Bazaar has been progressing in every way. Could you share what was the idea behind the Galaxy Bazaar?
Oh, lovely. There is a very, very interesting story behind, you know, how Galaxy Bazaar came into existence. this was year 2005, and, you know, I was deployed as a commerce teacher for this famous batch 10F, right, in SN Kansagra School. And, I was not knowing much about this particular batch, but, you know, what you can say, notorious is the right word, you know, to describe this particular batch. Just 28 young, innocent-looking children, you know, but they are the ones who have been instrumental in doing many things within the school. And believe me, there was a lot of behavioral issues with these children. So right before I was deployed, you know, I simply got to know that two teachers have already resigned. And that is because of, this particular batch, Yeah, so yes. They, you can understand that, you know, they were known for, you know, pulling the legs of the teachers and, you know, all kind of pranks and everything.
Yes, SNKs are particularly known for this.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yes. And, you know, when I was just, you know, deployed as their commerce teacher, I was like, you know, initially I was like, you know, what am I supposed to be doing? Am I going to be the third one? You know, two teachers have already gone. Will I be the third one who will give up? But then when I started working with these children, I simply realized that there is nothing wrong with these children. You know, they are very, very intelligent. They are very curious about many things. But what puts them off, or, you know, what really makes them, you know, kind of having some kind of, you know, what you can say, the classroom behavioral issues, is that they are getting bored. I'm teaching them commerce and I'm teaching them out of the book. Now, this is this particular subject, it is just like, you know, teaching somebody how to swim from the textbook, right? It's a practical subject. Yeah. And, you know, you are teaching them from the book and you are taking the tests and you're really making it so boring. So looking at, like, you know, after having a lot of discussion with them, one fine day, I simply told them that, you know, okay, let's have a deal. I will not teach you the chapters, but instead of that, we will simply set up this particular project before Diwali. And, you know, we will call it Galaxy Bazaar. Like, you know, it was the first year, it was the big business bang. We called it the big business bang. Believe me, the class came alive. You know, everybody was happy that, wow, we don't have to study all the commerce subjects. Now, instead of that, we'll be able to go out into the market. We'll be able to talk to the real people, real products, real profit, real losses, everything real. So that is something that brought about such a lot of excitement, you know, amongst the students. And I said, you know, bingo, now I know what works with these children, right? Mm-hmm. And we simply thought of that, you know, right before Diwali, we will have this particular bazaar. It was a very small bazaar with, you know, we used hardly 5 classrooms. You know, these classrooms were converted into the bazaar with, you know, using all the school furniture and stuff like that. But what I had seen at the end of this entire 3 days is that all the students who are not ready to budge in the classroom were the most actively learning. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And they were learning from the real people. They were actually learning, you know, from the real circumstances. And it worked so well, in the sense, like, you know, we had such a lot of fun. And believe me, whatever that I had to teach them in the classroom was all covered. Marketing was covered. Human resources was covered. English as the language was covered. You know, accountancy was covered. Every single thing was covered. At the end of 3 days, we simply, you know, had our accounting done, and we simply realized that we have made a profit of 8,000 rupees. Now the question is, when we started off, we had never decided that what will we be doing with the profits. So once again, I took that as a teaching opportunity, and I said, you know, we have 8,000 rupees. Let's kind of discuss, you know, what are different ways in which we can spend this 8,000 rupees. And this being teenagers, you know, I started receiving all kinds of, you know, suggestions that we will go and have a pizza party and we will go and have some nice, you know, frappe coffee or ice cream or this or that. Then they started coming up with all the ideas of, you know, how we can have fun with this 8,000 rupees. During Galaxy Bazaar, you know, whatever that we did, it was all in a democratic manner. So it is not that, you know, what I say, that becomes the decision. You know, we take the decision together after a lot of discussions, and whatever we think is logical, you know, becomes the decision. So and they had given all their choices, and I had just put my choice over there. I said, you know, we have one public school right across our school. Now, with this 8,000 rupee, if we are buying some stationery, believe me, that would be good enough for the children for entire year. Yeah, it will be sufficient, you know, for these children for entire year. And believe me, that was the turning point for these kids, because these children have never thought that, you know, the money that they can blow within 1 hour, or, you know, by just, you know, guzzling a cup of coffees, or, you know, having a couple of pizzas, can actually bring about a change in somebody's life, can support somebody's education. So those, at that particular point in time, it was a revelation. And believe me, with like unanimously, we had decided that we are going to be donating this money to provide, you know, some educational opportunity to the children. And something that we started in that particular year, we continued with that objective even after 14 Galaxy Bazaars. Be it 8,000 rupee, we donated. Be it 30 lakh of rupee, we donated. Yeah, not partaking a single rupee out of it, but simply working for somebody. In fact, you know, we found our purpose. We found our calling that, you know, it's not only that we are going to have Galaxy Bazaar to teach students about ethical entrepreneurship, but now we have a purpose. We are earning money so that we can provide educational opportunities to the children who are not as fortunate as us. And that gave us the strength. And that is what separates Galaxy Bazaar from many other projects.
Yes, definitely. And I remember when the Galaxy Bazaar started, probably not in 2005, but later on, after 2-3 years, I was noticing it. And you know, the way you mentioned it, was it started off with the classroom. So that's, I remember from classrooms, it got shifted to the, the courtyard, and then it was getting just huge. And so, so glad and so happy to hear this entire journey.
Dviti, you will be amazed that, you know, after that particular year, the 28 children who were kind of, you know, on the verge of getting an LC, of that
condition,
I could see the change in their, you know, a massive change in their behavior. Like, you know, out of 28 in 11th standard, nearly 16 of them were part of the council members. Yeah, so they were, you know, the leaders. So
yes,
it is not just, you know, a project, but this is the project which is also helping them becoming the better human beings. And that is why after 2005, in 2006, we didn't have Galaxy Bazaar, because I thought that, you know, it was just 1 year wonder and, you know, we are done. You know, kids had a good time and we are done with this. 2006, no Galaxy Bazaar was there. But in 2007, when these children were in grade 12 again, Dviti, I think you can understand this, that, you know, whenever there are board years, usually parents are simply saying, don't do anything, focus only on your exams. Yes. And only on your academics. So in grade 12, 2007, I had parents coming to me and simply requesting me that, you know, something that you had done in grade 10 had a marvelous effect on our children, and we want you to once again do it. So from 2007 onwards, we have simply, you know, started. That is where, you know, it was termed Galaxy Bazaar. And ever since 2007, we have not missed out a single year till last year. Like, you know, unfortunately, last year.
Last year is not to be counted.
Because of COVID, we couldn't do it. Yeah. But we have been doing it, and more than anything, you know, it has also inculcated a sense of, you know, what you can say, the brotherhood amongst the students. Because, you know, grade 11, you are the one who is kind of exploring everything. When you come to grade 12, you take on more responsibilities and lead the bazaar, and you simply try to help grade 11, you know, your juniors, with all the mistakes that you have made, you know, you are sharing it with them. So a lot of such interpersonal relationships have also been developed because of Galaxy Bazaar. So it's not just a bazaar. It's like a plethora of, you know, so many things, skills happening, knowledge happening, relationships happening, everything.
And also we can say that it was a sort of, it has been, it's not like it's not, we're going to have it in 2021. I'm looking forward to it.
So, absolutely.
So probably, you know, we can say that it was sort of like, you know, we have this pottery done wherein the pot gets molded into a beautiful shape. So while, you know, all these experiences, all these hurdles and the enjoyment also and the learning process, it becomes so beautiful in molding one person, and especially at that sensitive time where they're in 11th grade and 12th grade. So that's really, really wonderful, ma'am.
And, Dviti, and you know, I will just, you know, I would like to bring this to your notice that, you know, through Galaxy Bazaar, you know, we are also trying to make students think. Let's say, I'll give you a very simple example. You know, that is also, you know, one of my objectives. Like, you know, I'll give you very simple examples. Every year we have Galaxy Bazaar before Diwali. And now, you know, whenever it is before Diwali, you know, one of the most profitable product that you can sell is firecrackers. You know that, you know, with this age group, you know, every firecrackers will be, you know, absolute hit, and, you know, you will be able to run into a lot of profits. But once again, you know, we sit together as the team and we try to think about it that, you know, is this particular product helping the community? And that is where students learn that, you know, firecrackers, even though we will get more profits, it is not adding, you know, positively to the environment. You know, lots of air pollution. Not only that, there is child labor, you know, so far as making of firecrackers are concerned. So they go deeper into the making of the product, the effect of the product, and then they simply take a decision whether they want to sell that product or not. Now, this is something, if all the business houses start doing this, where they are not lured purely by profits, but they are considering all the stakeholders and the positive impact of the business, believe me, world will be a better place, you know, if something like that happens.
Yes, it will. We can at least hope and pray for that. It happens very soon. So, you know, I've heard about Galaxy Bazaar. Every year, there's a special name given to Galaxy Bazaar. And at one year, I remember it was Galaxy Bazaar United. So could you let me know, or could you let us know the, you know, what were the names and what was the idea behind it particularly?
All right. See, initially, what we are used to do is that, you know, to give a different identity to each Galaxy Bazaar, you know, so that every batch will have that kind of connect that I was part of, you know, this particular Galaxy Bazaar, you know. So right from Carnival to, you know, Galaxy Bazaar, like, you know, you won't believe there are out of 14 years, for we had different names for Galaxy Bazaar for nearly 10 years. And after that, you know, we started, you know, calling it only Galaxy Bazaar, followed by the year. You know, we started building the brand, like, you know, a common brand which is known into the market. Only the year changes. So every year, initially, what was happening was that once again, students will be the ones who will be suggesting the name. That, you know, we will have nearly 100-150 names, you know, given by students, and out of that, you know, we simply pick and choose which is the most popular one. After that, you know, the students are the ones who will be creating a logo with that particular, you know, what you can say, initials. Yeah. So, you know, once again, we will receive, you know, nearly 60, 70 designs. And then, so there is a lot of, you know, what you can say, ownership. It's not something that, you know, you hire a graphic designer, you name it this, and you hire a graphic designer, make a logo, nothing like that. It is your event. You create the logo, you create the advertisements, the posters, everything. Everything is run by students, done by students, and, you know, executed by students.
Lovely. Hello, Sujata ma'am. It's so lovely to see your comment, ma'am. I hope you're doing good. And thank you, Rupali Tanna, for your comments also. So talking, we've talked about Galaxy Bazaar, and there's this hackathon, which is also going on alongside Galaxy Bazaar. So could you let us know what is so special about hackathon?
All right. See, I started hackathon in the year 2008. But my objective for having the hackathon was a little different from that of Galaxy Bazaar. Being in this particular, like, you know, as a teacher, I have simply realized that in our Indian education system, we are compartmentalizing the subjects. Like, you know, the moment you take up science, you are now limited to, you know, PCMB. You know, the moment you take up commerce, you are limited to, let's say, economics and accounts and commerce and those kind of subjects. So we are compartmentalizing the subjects. But if you look at it, you know, you want to become a good, successful entrepreneur, you need a bit of all the three streams. You know, you need to understand the arts, you need to understand the sciences, you need to understand, you know, business or entrepreneurship as well. So unfortunately, there was nothing at the school system or at the education level that was happening to do that. you know, wherein you're simply integrating the subjects and giving it to the students. So I simply started with this particular project called, we called it IPM, Innovative Product and Marketing Competition. So the name itself is very clear, like, you know, basically what students do is they look around their own community, look for a problem. Now, the thing is, you know, when you're a teenager and when you come across a problem, you know, what is your natural reaction? You start blaming. You start blaming your school, you start blaming your parents, you start blaming your country, the government, everybody. Right?
We can reach to the entire world, yes.
So instead of that, you know, because of this particular competition, you look around it. You kind of, you know, look around your own community and find problems, you know, try to look at the problems. But now once you have the problems with you, you are going to solve that problem not by just thinking about an innovative idea, but by creating an innovative product. Now, there is a vast difference between just thinking that, you know, I will, it's just like, you know, I will do this and, you know, actually doing it. Yeah. So when this task is given to the students, a lot of things starts happening, you know, integration of lot of subjects. Like a commerce student starts thinking about product engineering, he starts about design thinking, he starts, you know, thinking about many, like, you know, the pricing decisions, the customer psychology, legal, you know, the laws regarding the products, everything. They start, so basically, you know, through this, we are trying to give the context. We are giving them a problem and we are simply saying, solve this problem. And in the process, whatever that you wish to, whatever that you come across, you know, find your own answers. Mm-hmm. And believe me, you know, students, once again, enjoy this process so much. The initial, this is like, you know, when you tell students that come up with some innovative product, the initial stage is always, you know, I will make a car which is flying, and I'll make a car which is, and I'll make a car which is like, you know, turning into a satellite. And, you know, do you understand? A very, very huge innovations. Students think that, you know, innovations meaning you have to do something like, you know, technically engineered product. But then slowly and steadily, you know, we simply talk to them and bring them to that particular point when they come up with real problems around them, and they come up with real solutions. And I'll give you a very simple example. One particular team a couple of years back, you know, had come up with a product called Clapper Bulb. Now, you know, how they had come up with this particular idea? See, they had their grandparents, and they had seen their grandparents getting up frequently in the night. And what was happening is that, you know, where the bed was located and where the switchboard was, there was a distance. And, you know, you are constantly worrying about that they should not have a fall because, you know, there is no light there, right? So that was a problem that they had identified. See, the same, the problem which is in your house, you know, you are not going anywhere. It's your own house, your own people, they are facing a problem and you have identified it. Of course, it makes you, you know, kind of more empathetic. You start looking at the problems, you know, which you usually don't. And they had come up with this particular product called Clapper Bulb, wherein with one clap, the bulb switches on, and with two claps, switches off. So now grandparents.
A 12th or a 10th grade student, and that's really wonderful.
Exactly. And these are common students, you know, but they have gone out, talked to the engineers, they have found out, you know, what technology will go into it. They have struggled, they have failed, they have done everything. But then they come up with this particular product, and not only the product, they also have to create a marketing plan to market this product. Now, you know, see, any product, there are so many products which are good, but are they sellable? You know, are they, you know, will somebody in the market pay a price for it? And if yes, you know, how will you market it? Very, very important to understand that. So they have to create an entire marketing plan, wherein right from company name to designing a company or product logo to, you know, the print media like, you know, a newspaper and magazine advertisement to, you know, recording their own radio jingle. They'll write the lyrics, they find the music, sometimes they create the music, they record their own jingle. They also create television advertisement. So So somebody becomes the director, there is a, you know, script, there are dialogues, so somebody becomes the director, somebody becomes the light boy, somebody stars into that particular advertisement. You know, they also create websites, they also create, you know, the social media pages. So a lot of fun. And in the process, you are learning the technology, you are learning, you know, what to do, what not to do. You start looking at the media differently. Believe me, the moment they have to do it, they start looking at the newspaper and they start, you know, that where this advertisement, you know, the location of the advertisement, you know, should I put it on the last page, corner, middle, color, black and white? Like, you know, there are so many.
Yes.
And they learn such a lot. They have such a lot of fun. And then they present their entire product and their marketing plan in front of the panel of judges. Mm-hmm. So believe me, you know that very well, that there are so many students who have this kind of, like, you know, communication fear. Like, you know, there is a stage fear. You know, they they avoid, you know, talking whenever any kind of opportunity is given. Now, this takes care of that as well. You know, something as simple as that, when you are on the stage, how to stand. You know, there are so many students who don't know what to do with their hands. Yeah, whether I have to have this. So there are so much of learning at every step and turn that, you know, students get to know that, you know, if there are five of us and if we are presenting, we have 10 minutes. How can we impress the judges and we tell them everything that we have done? And it is so much of fun. And, you know, hackathon is something that is so close to my heart. Just last year, we started having the theme-based hackathons. So we had the theme of UN SDGs. I think something that is so, so important, but, you know, very few people are aware of. United Nations has come up with 17, you know, sustainable development goals, which have to be fulfilled by 2030. If not, we will be in trouble. And we can see that climate change is one of the goals. Like, you know, climate is one of the goals that they have. So I introduced them to UN SDGs, and all their innovations were kind of, you know, streamed towards solving the problems of this United, you know, 17 UN SDGs. So it is a lot of fun, lot of learning. And, you know, we have fun together.
Definitely. It's learning and fun together. And I'm going to say this from the behalf of all these students since all these years. I'm going to take this opportunity and say that, you know, this Galaxy Bazaar and Hackathon is definitely grooming them up for the times that they're going to step out in the world, when they're going to complete their schooling, when they're going to complete their college. And after college, when they're going out in the world, I'm sure that not even one student would have faced any difficulties in leading the life that they have to after completing the college. Because, you know, the Galaxy Bazaar and Hackathon gives entire, you know, it's a complete package which gives you an entire idea of how is it going to be when you step outside in the world. So it's definitely a wonderful thing, ma'am. And I'm going to thank you from behalf of all these students. I'm going to take this opportunity in thanking you for bringing Galaxy Bazaar and Hackathon to TGS. Yes.
You know, see, Dwiti, I must say that, you know, there are so many students who turn entrepreneurs, you know, after finishing their degrees and everything. And that is when they come back to me and simply saying that, ma'am, you know, starting my business was piece of cake because, you know, we had already done when we were in the school. Now all we have to do is just replicate that experience. And, you know, whatever that we had learned is something that we have to now put it into practice.
Into practice, exactly, yes.
Definitely. And believe me, it is our school, you know, which has given us this particular platform, you know, because there is a lot of flexibility that needs to be given. You know, you cannot do Galaxy Bazaar or IPM with the rigid timetables. You know, you are getting into the time of many teachers. Like, you know, you are taking away that, you know, sir, please don't teach economics today. I need the students.
You know? Yeah, to attend. Yes, definitely. Yes. And while talking about school and teachers, I'm going to talk about Kiran sir being so, so wonderful and supportive of everything that the students and the teachers want to do. So thank you so much, Kiran sir. I'm going to take this opportunity again in thanking you. So, yes. And hi, Vandit. Hi, Dhanraj. And hi, Rupali. Thank you so much for joining us today. So moving forward, you know, when we were having this discussion, you mentioned something about when students in the 12th grade are asked about what do you want to become when you get out of your school or when you complete your college, you know, and usually right. they answer like, I want to become an engineer or a doctor or sort of like all the basic and the normal answers that every student might give. But right. there was this, you know, the gap where no one answered or no one usually answers. Even I remember that no one answered in my batch or from my class that I want to become a teacher, you know. So what will be your message to the 12th grade or to the 10th grade or all these students out there who can pursue this, you know, as a profession?
See, Dwiti, if you look at it, you know, this is very unfortunate and this is not something that is, you know, related to our city or our country. This is a global problem where there is an acute shortage of good teachers, you know, acute shortage of teachers. And at the same time, the ones who are in the teaching profession are kind of, you know, being burnt out and they are stepping out, you know, taking up other professions and, you know, taking up other opportunities. And at the same time, the younger generation, nobody aspires to become a teacher. You know, that is the sad part of today. Everybody wants good teachers, but nobody wants to become a good teacher himself or herself, right? So basically, a problem like this is occurring for the simple reason that, see, people may think, you know, people may perceive that, you know, job of teacher is so simple. You know, you have just a textbook, just teach it. Correct a couple of papers, take a couple of tests, and your job is done. You know, people say, oh, you enjoy summer vacation. So, so lucky. We don't get it, you know, in our corporate jobs. But that is not the case. You know, that is definitely not the case. Teachers are actually working day and night. And believe me, you know, their contribution is not measurable. See, if I'm a marketing manager, I can say that I have sold 1,000 units. But as a teacher, my impact will be seen probably 20 years down the road, you know, when one of the students simply comes and says that, ma'am, you made the difference in my life and I'm what I am today because of you. So, you know, it is, you know, there is a delayed gratification in this particular profession. Unfortunately, you know, people don't want to become teachers because they do not see it as a profession. You know, just the way I see that I become a doctor or I become an engineer or I become like, you know, people will have there is a social stigma as well that, you know, oh, you are a teacher. Well, there is a master image, you know, the moment you say teacher. Yeah. So we have to change that. Being teachers, we have to be, you know, become the professionals that we are at par with other professions. That includes pay, that includes opportunities, that includes, you know, the status. When we do that, you know, Finland has done that. You know, Finland has done where, you know, the best of the minds first go to become a teacher. You know, over there they say that, unfortunately, I couldn't become a teacher and that's why I became doctor or engineer. You know, that is...
That's the second profession that they choose, yes.
So, I think that kind of, you know, what you can say, the mindset needs to be developed in our country wherein, you know, teachers are at par with other professionals in all the ways. And you know, and that is true even for teachers, that, you know, you will have to keep yourself updated, you know, because if you're a professional, it is not something that you know, you are teaching the same curriculum 20 years, you know, you have made one lesson plan and chalta hai, you know, for next 20 years. If you're a professional, you have to explore yourself, you have to develop yourselves, become a role model, and then I think many students will be influenced positively to become teachers. I hope and I pray to God that this happens.
Definitely. And can we say that, you know, generally these days what I have been noticing is people usually tend to comment a lot on social media saying, you know, things need to change in the society, things need to change in and around us. So yeah, you know, probably what needs to change is actually, you know, the upbringing and, you know, the development of the child or for the teenage while they are in school. And to do that, the only way is to, you know, become a teacher, become an educator, and bring about a change in the real world. And that's really the way we can help others also.
That reminds me of, you know, my favorite quote by Mahatma Gandhi, be the change you want to see in the world. Like, you know, you want to do something, if you think something needs to change, start with you. You know, you make changes to that. and you know the world will follow.
Yes, definitely. Absolutely. Hello, Reena ma'am. It's so good to see such familiar names and faces today. I'm so overwhelmed. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining. So, you know, talking about all the achievements and the awards, which I proudly mentioned, what was your feeling and what has been your journey? You know, you've been awarded as many national and international awards, such as the Global Teacher Prize 2015, which is probably right. The highest global recognition for any educator. Right. Another one is also Forbes Good Smart in 2014 and two Outstanding Teacher Award, which in itself is a great achievement. So will you share your experience in winning such great awards?
Dwiti, whenever you are doing some good work, awards or recognition is the byproduct of it. You know, automatically people will take note of what you are doing. And, you know, they will simply try to bring it to the platform where everybody will get to know about what you're doing. It so you know whatever that you're doing is not limited to the classroom anymore. Now there are so many people who would like to know what you are doing and replicate if possible. You know, the good practices are always replicated around the world, and it should. So awards, as I said, that I do not look at awards as any glory or anything like that. I just take awards because it opens up lot of doors of opportunities for me. I get to travel a lot because of that. I have been to United States 6 times, every time, for receiving an award. And, I get to meet so many amazing educators. I get to know so many organizations which are doing a great job. So basically, it provides me the platform, you know. So award per se, it's good. But, you know, now I know that, you know, if I want to talk to somebody in ACD, if I want to talk to somebody in ISTE, if I want to talk to somebody in Microsoft, Google, anywhere, I know that I have a family of educators. Like, you know, I have somebody, you know, who will be helping me out with my own professional development. And that is so exciting about awards.
Wow. And I've been really happy. I'm always following you, and you're here and you're there and you're receiving every award. And I was like so, so proud and happy for that. And many congratulations for all the achievements.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yes. And so talking about, you've also delivered 2 TEDx speech, if I'm not wrong. And you've had many, seminars and conferences where you've been, either you've attended or either you've taken up. So what has been your experience during all these events?
As I mentioned, just like awards, you know, it is actually giving you an opportunity to kind of, you know, step out of your comfort zone, share your best practices with the world, learn something, you know, from the other educators, you know, make friends, have a good network of educators who are just like you, you know, who would like to learn, who would like to explore, who would like to do something exciting. So whenever you go for any conference, and of course, point number one is you get to share your classroom practice and share it with other teachers. And of course, you can attend the sessions and learn what is happening in the world, and keeping yourself updated. Like, you know, that is something that helps you step outside, the four boundaries of your own classroom or your own school or your own city or your own country. You know that you know, okay, fine, this is good, I'm doing it, but there are other people or other educators from other countries who are doing this, and if it is good, just talk to them and start with some project across. And this is something that I also believe in, that we have to bring our students to become the global citizens, and that is where a lot of empathy comes in. When you have somebody from a different background or a different belief system or a different religion coming in. Unfortunately, in Rajkot, we don't get that kind of diversity. But when you connect students globally, there is one particular program called Empatico. That is where we do it. We connect students, second, third, fourth standard students, get connected to nearly 15 to 20 countries around the world. And the learning that has, we have our students, simply let's say, doing some Russian dance. You know, this is such a lot of fun and such a lot of, and we will have Russian girls doing Garba there. So this is learning, real-time learning.
And now that you mentioned the thing about students, so even, you know, the students who studied under you, you know, they've gone out and they've achieved so much. So how has been your experience regarding when they look back at you and when they look back at the school time? And when you get to know that, oh, this person is up to this thing, you know, so how is the experience over there?
I think I'm talking to one of them right now.
Oh, my goodness.
And no, really, you know, it is so interesting. You know, I do have, you know, a couple of students who are now my colleagues. You know, they have become teachers and they are teaching along with me. And, you know, it's really amazing to see their processes, you know, how they have grown and how they have decided to become teachers and how wonderful they are right now, you know, simply bringing about a difference in people's lives, students' lives. And there are many times, you know, when students, let's say after 5 or 6 years of graduation, they have achieved such a lot, like, you know, they have become chartered accountants or big business people or, you know, but when they come and touch your legs, you know, you know, in our school, we do this, you know, namaste and, you know, pranam, you know, what you can say, this, tradition. Really, you really feel good that whatever hard work, whatever that you have put in, it's worth it. That you have managed to kind of, you know, give community some good people. And they're the one who will take it forward, you know, from here.
Yes, and that is going to remain with them till their lifetime, you know. And I know, being one student and being an SNK, that it remains with me every single step of my life. And I'm so grateful for that.
Yes. Absolutely.
So apart from the educator and apart from all the business and student and school life, I know a few things about you, which are, you know, a few passion of yours and few hobby of yours, which are completely different from your profession. So what are those? And I'm going to listen few lines from you. I'm not going to leave those conversations without that.
Sure you do. I'm sure that at least, you know, one thing that you are 100%.
You're into martial arts, you were into karate, you were into tabla, guitar and ghazal writing. So what more? Right. And the journey.
See, these have been my passion. Like, of course, during my school and during my college time, I was into sports, and martial art was something that was so close to my heart. And let me, I think, tell the audience that Dwiti's dad used to be my guru. Yeah, he's the one who has taken me from white belt to black belt, you know, in karate, and brown belt in judo. So that is something that I was really, really passionate about for the simple reason that martial art is something that teaches you to be gentle. You know, martial art is not, you know, something, it's not the strength of body, it's the strength of mind. And I really enjoyed, I evolved from nothing to, you know, let's say till my black belt, journey of black belt, I really enjoyed every aspect. And even right now, of course, not exercising much, but that stays with you, you know, whatever that you have learned at that point in time, you know, that discipline of mind, discipline of heart, that stays with you forever. So that is one thing. I was into sports, I was into traveling, like, you know, trekking into Himalayas and exploring different you know, what you can say, destinations and cultures and all that. And of course, I was into music. Yes, so music is something that, you know, it has always been close to my heart. So one is, you know, as a listener, I was used to be a very, very good listener so far as ghazals were concerned. You know, that is the genre of music which was
really do write ghazals of your own. And I'm gonna, you know, I'm not gonna leave you until I hear a few lines. And I'm sure every student out there and every audience out there who are connected with us, they would definitely love to hear those lines from you.
See, the thing is, you know, I have, like, during college days and all, I have written, like, nearly, you know, let's say 500, 600 ghazals. Usually, they are, like, you know, these ghazals are in Gujarati. right? And I think this facet of my personality, very few people know about that I have been writing. Yes. So okay, let me kind of, you know, share at least one with you. Just a minute.
Any one of your, like, anyone, if it's your favorite or at any time that you've written.
I didn't get time to choose the favorite, but, you know, there is one which I simply, you know, I picked up the diary and here it is. So I think I'll share it with you. Okay. Koi sabandh jode ke tode, teni marji. Koi kalam rakt ma jabode, eni marji. Pratibimb ma farak kaso padse nahi kadi. Koi lakh aina fode, eni marji. करीशो प्रतीक्षण ज्यांथी पड़िया विखूटा आपड़े कोई गम्मे तेटलू दौड़े तेनी मर्जी चालियो जाए कोई कशा कारण वगर ने कोई टोड़ा मा सतत एने खोड़े एनी मर्जी अभिव्यक्ति दुखनी छे सवनी अलग अलग कोई रड़ीले छानू ने कोई वड़े टोड़े एनी मर्जी मार हड़सेलो आ अदबीड़ायला छे बारणा मार हड़सेलो आ अदबीड़ायला छे बारणा छत्ता ते दीवाल तोड़े तो तेनी मर्जी बदली नथी शकवाना एनाथी चेहराना नाक नक्श बदली नथी शकवाना एनाथी चेहराना नाक नक्श वाड़ भले ए जुदी रीते ओड़े एनी मर्जी गांधी ने कोई मारे गोड़ी कोई ईसु ने वध स्तंभ ऊपर खोड़े एनी मर्जी.
Wow, I am actually speechless because I knew you, right? But I didn't. Yeah. I haven't heard this from you before. So wow, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can you plan to, you know, publish it?
During my school days, my principal, you know, Usha Ben Jani, who was very inspirational, you know, for kind of inspiring me to write, she wanted to publish, you know, all my poems. But unfortunately, I don't know, I have kept it personal, in the sense, you know, I write just for my own pleasure, nothing else.
Okay, I'll hope, fingers crossed, that someday probably I might get to see, you know, those lines getting published. So, okay.
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed. Yes, definitely fingers crossed.
I just want to, you know, just bring up, like, you know, mention one thing over here. As I said, Usha Ben Jani, you know, my principal, yes. I have studied in Sister Nivedita School in Rajkot. So she was the principal there. And believe me, see, this is the influence of a teacher. As a Gujarati teacher, believe me, she had never pressurized me to, you know, pay attention to what she is teaching. You know, she will kind of, you know, let me look outside the window, and believe me, at the end of Gujarati class, I'll go to her with, let's say, a ghazal or a poem or a haiku. And, you know, she'll simply say, this is fine. This is your learning. You know, you don't have to study whatever I'm teaching. You create whatever that you wish to create. So I think the influence of the teacher goes a long, long way.
Yes, it does. It does. We're sharing the bond, so it does go a long way. Even after these years, it's so fresh in the memory, and it's just wonderful. So what are the future plans, like 2021? 2020 is gone and we're just like keeping it aside, but 2021, Galaxy Bazaar, Hackathon, and what else?
Basically, I would like to kind of, you know, come up with an institution where we can start providing the entrepreneurship and innovation and research, you know, what you can say, abilities to the students as young as, let's say, you know, third grader or fourth grader or anything. I see Galaxy Bazaar being global, like, you know, not being limited to SN Kansagra or DG.
Yes, definitely.
For the simple reason that, you know, if one teacher and her students can raise 1 crore 50 lakhs in 14 years and can help 5,200 girls, imagine what if, you know, 100 schools are doing that. You know, it will be the force multiplier. We will be able to help so many children go to the school, and we will have so many students with the ethical entrepreneurship training, you know, given to them. So that is what I'm looking forward to, coming up with something, you know, scaling whatever that I'm doing and making it available to many schools, you know, not only one school. And I'm sure, you know, Kiran sir will be a kind of, you know, will be open to that and will be helping me with that.
Definitely, Kiran sir, are you hearing out? I hope you're listening to us currently, because yes, what Biju ma'am said is definitely, even every student will be wishing that, you know, this thing goes globally and everyone can be a part of it or contribute in whatever way they can, and that's see you know, Galaxy Bazaar, TGS and SNK going globally.
Absolutely.
Yes. So, okay. Thank you, Kajal Patel, Vikram and Bela Kamani. Thank you so much for joining. Okay, so we're going to end this up, conclude this with one message that you want to give out to the students, to the audience of the Eternal Quest, and to all the educators out there.
There is, you know, I think... the message is very simple. As I said, you know, I will once again quote Mahatma Gandhi, be the change that you want to see in the world. And no matter whatever that you are doing, you know, take two things with you. One is passion and second is compassion. You know, do it with passion. You know, give all, everything that you have. Find your ikigai, find the purpose of your life, and then dedicate all your energy, you know, in the fulfillment of that particular mission of your life. And in that process, be compassionate. You know, don't be greedy. You know, money may come, money may go, but, you know, be compassionate. Make sure that you are taking care of all the stakeholders who are directly or indirectly connected with your projects or with your businesses or whatever that you're doing. I think that is it. If you have this too, half of the battle is won.
Yes, definitely. Lovely, ma'am. Lovely. Thank you. So one that says, I will be the first one to take, but one that I'm here also, like, see, two people are already in. And I'm sure that everyone is going to be, you know, really happy to join this entire process. So, okay.
Has been part of the core committee of Galaxy Bazaar and has done a wonderful, wonderful job. Just, you know, graduated 2 years back. And, you know, he's somebody who is so serious.
Yes, he's mentioned that, you know, people search for ideas to start business, and IPM has many of them, and some are multi-million dollar ideas, and all credits goes to Bijal ma'am for initiating.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so we're going to wrap this up with a quick rapid fire round.
Okay.
Your favorite batch. 20 years to favorite batch.
Okay. This is just like asking the mother, you know, who is your favorite child?
Yeah, I'm going to put it in the zone. That's why I mentioned.
So, you know, every batch is unique. Every batch brings something very unique about them. And, you know, so there is nothing, no favorite batches. In fact, I love each and every student, each and every batch that I have taught.
Okay. The most notorious one?
Ah, the 10F. The 10F takes credit for that in the year 2005. And they are the ones who inspired me to start with Galaxy Bazaar. So I'm actually thankful to them that, you know, they made me a better teacher. They actually made me understand, you know, what education should be. So thank you, guys.
Okay. And the most studious one, like the most serious one?
Not a single one.
Not a single one. We SNKs are not known for the studious part.
And in fact, you know, even if they come to 11th standard as the studious ones, I make sure that they don't remain one. Because, you know, just, you know, bookish knowledge is not going to take you anywhere. So even if you are at the studious one, the bookworm, we are here to, you know, change you into, you know, somebody who is flamboyant, somebody who is outgoing.
Okay, so teaching or ghazals, writing ghazals?
Ah, that's a tough one.
Yes.
That's a tough one.
I'm asking this question particularly because I want to see those ghazals getting published into a book. I'm going to mention it again. I'm going to push you for that.
Yeah, see, both are my passions in the sense, like, you know, teaching is something that, of course, you know, as I said, it's my ikigai where I have converted my passion into my profession. Whereas ghazal is something which is more, what you can say, something that I do as a hobby, something that I do as expression of myself, as, you know, I try to put my, you know, thoughts onto the, you know, put the pen and paper together and try to, you know, record them. That's it. So I really don't know. there is no one specific answer to that.
Okay. One message that you would want to give to the younger self of yours.
Believe in yourselves. Work hard. Don't think there is a shortcut to success. Nobody, even Elon Musk or, you know, anybody that you look at, you know, you're just looking at the, what you can say, the end product. Believe me, everybody goes through that grind. Everybody goes through that hard work, failure, everything. So believe in yourself. Work hard, honestly. And then, you know, just have the success that you deserve. No shortcuts.
Yes, no shortcuts. Okay. So what is your favorite time of the school, like the assembly or the break, the lunch break or the short break or mid break that we have?
Once again, a tough question because, you know, assemblies are something that you love. Like, you know, you start your morning.
I immensely miss the assemblies, to be very
absolutely. You know, so right from, you know, Nitin sir's singing to, you know, all the musicians.
Oh my God, yes.
Beautiful, 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 you know, bhajans and everything. Nobody would like to miss that morning time. And, you know, that's the right way to start, you know, your day.
Yes.
But at the same time, you know, the breaks are important because, you know, you get the time to kind of unwind. You know, most of my breaks I would spend with Sujata ma'am. And we'll be discussing so many things what happened, how, you know, we kind of, you know, compare notes and guide each other, have fun, relax. So I think both are important in its own way.
Especially during the assembly, hearing Kiran sir, you know, in the morning, hearing his words and his speech is like, it's a great start of the day.
Absolutely. And, you know, so even students coming and, you know, speaking in all three different languages, like, you know, believe me, you get to know
recitations and everything.
So much of fun.
Yes, definitely. Hello, Priyanka ma'am. Thank you so much for joining, ma'am. And hi, Ravi. Thank you for the comment. Okay, so we're going to end this up with thank you. Thank you so much. I'm actually running out of words to, you know, thank you for taking out such time from your schedule and just joining with us and being here and sharing the experience of your journey. And it's been, it will be a great opportunity for me to translate your ghazals into English. See, every student wants to do that, ma'am. Dhanraj is saying the same. Yes, Dhanraj, fingers crossed. We're gonna push her and we're gonna really be nudging her with the thought that please publish the book. Yes.
No, yes. Definitely. Yes. Think about it. And thank you so much, Dwiti, and, you know, thank you so much, the Eternal Quest and Ahmedabad Book Club, for giving me this opportunity and having me. Really, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Kiran sir. Thank you, SNK. Thank you, DGES. And thank you to all the wonderful people that joined us today. And thank you to all my teachers. And thank you, Beedle ma'am, for, you know, I'm going to take this opportunity and this chance to thank every one of them who've been a part of this entire journey and the entire process of Beedle ma'am and me. And thank you so much. It means
thank
a
you.
Lot. Have you,
you
to share the screen with my own teacher and educator. It's such an honor. Thank you so much.
We had a lot of fun, Dwiti. Thank you so much.
Definitely.
In the
yes.
school I'm on right now. Thank you so much.
Yes. So to all the audience and the viewers, thank you for joining us today. And do let us know in the comment section below, how did you find this video regarding Ms. Beedle Damani as an educator of the SN Kansagra School, Rajkot, Gujarat. And we're going to be back in another week with another guest. And thank you so much for showing all the love and support. We've been receiving immense love and support from you guys. Just keep doing that. And we're going to see you in the next week. Till then, take care and bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye. Bye, ma'am.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.